Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas. Welcome to this video. Here we have one new build idea. This time the build is called the Troglodyte, because you know, in this game we have some enemies in Act of Hades that they are called Troglodytes. These are some very big green enemies. They look like mountains of meat for you to eat and to kill and cook it and eat it if you are hungry. The good thing about these enemies is that they have some mastery frequent items of their own, and they drop these items if you are lucky enough to get them, because these items are rare. The idea behind this build was to put all mastery frequent items of the Troglodytes on your character and make a build as good as it can be. And here we are. Those enemies are green also, and I equipped also a green looking armor. We can see there we have the boots, we have the braces, we have the weapon, and we have the helmet. These four items come from Troglodytes. And here we are. This build right now is a very very good one. It is very strong and very very good, very tanky I would say, because the resistances, if you take a look here, secondary resistances are about 80% perfect. This one is not perfect, but it is okay. This one is 0%, but okay, there are not that many enemies in the game that deal petrification. And the primary ones we have very 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 good. Perfect, perfect, almost perfect. This is very good. This is very good, but during combat this one goes up to 77%, because we use Onslaught, and with Onslaught we have a skill that increases our pierce and physical resistances. And we have good poison and okay bleeding. And we have on top of the rest of the physical damage mitigation coming from armor of items, we have 35% plus 17% that we get from this skill during combat, physical resistance. 17, 52%. So even though the torso armor has a low armor, the base armor of this one is low, it doesn't really matter that much now, because we get this very big amount of physical resistance. So this build is very very tanky, and it is very good also at dealing damage. It is a strong one. So let's start with the masteries. We will have some gameplay later. In Warfare Mastery I maxed out this one. We can see all the skills I have maxed out. This will get maxed out later. And I decided not to use, not to do dual wielding. I didn't want to equip two folks. I wanted to have some balance between my resistances and damage output. And in the Dream Mastery we have maxed out these things. This one, this one, and this one. So this is the state of the build. Why did I go with Dream and Warfare? Because both Warfare, especially Warfare, and of course Dream, they provide buffs to physical damage. This build is mostly physical damage. And this one, Dream Mastery, provides offensive defensive ability, which I needed. It provides physical damage here and vitality damage. I deal both. And here we get total speed assist to avoid projectiles, and also the slow resistance. Also we get this one, which is very important, because this is a close combat build. This one is an aura always active. This one reduces resistances of enemies, so we deal even more damage to those enemies. Always, constant more damage. And here we have this one. This one, which is an AoE attack, you hit with this one and you hit multiple enemies and you destroy them. So this class is very very good for this, for the purposes of this build. Now, why do I have Psionic Touch and Psionic Beam? I have Psionic Touch because it has Psionic Beam. I wanted to get plus 2 to all skills, at least plus 2, because I wanted to get this one up to a level 8. When you take it up to level 8, it says minus 2 charge levels, which means that every second attack with a psionic touch releases this effect of psionic touch, the total damage and vitality. And this is a very, very nice thing to have here at use, especially with this build, and also in combination with Onslaught. This also gives charge level. So what do? I attack my enemies with Onslaught, I charge up my levels, I get the plus 64% physical damage, and then, after I'm up there, to have this buffer from this effect, I start hitting with psionic touch. And since I attack very fast, my attack speed is not only 197, it is faster, because when I hit with Onslaught, I get this buff to attacking speed. So, by having this one charged up, and then attacking very, very fast with this one, I deal lots of damage. Because this one now gets the total damage buff and also this vitality damage on top of this buff. Of course, every second you do not attack with this one, you lose one charge. But if I can, every second after I have charged up this one, to apply this effect per second, then this is still a very, very good buff to damage output. So this is a combination of attacks. You attack with this one, you charge up this one, and when it is up to high levels, you start attacking with this one as fast as possible. And we have great speed. So we have these things here that help very much against enemies and against bosses, of course. And we have these things here. This reduces armor, so enemies receive even more damage now physical. This one provides resistances, and this one provides attack speed. Now for the items, let's begin with troglodytes. We have this Gog, this comes from troglodytes. This one is the robust of campaigning. This is why it has movement speed and health and strength percentages. And I went with this charm because I wanted to get more, resistances and balance out my survivability. Here we have Lara. I got this one from trading. This one is, it provides cold resistance and attack speed. The attack speed is the alacrity. It is of the alacrity, which is great. And I decided to go with a primal magma because this one provides fire damage, which is very, very good. Against, we have now some elemental damage against undead constructs and things like that, and also attack speed, which we need. This is why we have such high attack speed. Thanks to this item, and thanks to this item. This is a dire prefix of annihilation suffix. Dire provides 47 vitality damage, and annihilation suffix provides bonus damage and physical percentages. Remember that we have here this one, that says plus 51% vitality damage. So this 47 damage is not just 40, it is plus 51% vitality damage, and it is a little bit of a buff from this one. And of course it gets buffed up, not directly, from skills like this one, because this skill reduces all resistances of enemies, including vitality. So now this 47 vitality damage is much higher. Maybe it is 100, who knows. I decided to go with the Valor of Achilles to get as much attacking speed as possible here. And this is how we have 197%. And here we have the Atuk. This one is, it provides the prefix Stalwart, which provides plus 40 armor. Of Fortitude suffix, which provides Sleep and Skin Disruption Protection. And this is how we have such good secondary resistances here. Thanks to these items. And I decided to go with the Crystal of Erebos plus 2 to all skills because I wanted to get at least plus 2 to all skills on this build. Crosshair of Osiris. If I take it off, it goes down to 5%. And it also provides this skill Soul Drain, which is a good one. Every now and then you can use it and deal this kind of damage and buffs and stats and debuffs and whatnot. Here we have the Mantle of Sajan. I decided to go with this one because I wanted to balance out my survivability. This one provides many resistances, but not good base armor. But as I said before, we get added physical resistance. And this one goes even higher during combat. and it helps very much with the low numbers of this one. So the synergy between this one and this one is awesome. And so this means that we don't really have a big problem with this item here. It is a very nice item for this slot, for this specific build that has so much physical resistance. Here we have the Star of Elysium. I decided to go with this one because of the resistances, the physical damage buff, the health points, the strength, you know, health regen, all of these things. Here we have the Priam's Gate for the resistances. And here we have the Myrmidon Spended for the resistances at 43% physical damage at health. Also, the Warwind skill helps very much moving faster through maps. We have it down here. And last but not least, we have this resistant Kickles of the Tinkerer resistances and two charms or a charm and a relic that provide resistances, damage to demons, 12 reduced resistances for 4 seconds, which stacks on enemies that you hit with your weapon. This one also on enemies that are affected by this one. So you have 36% reduced resistances working on enemies, and you also have this one, the 12 reduced, which is a flat one, it is not percentage, it is an absolute one, and absolute ones will stack with percentages ones. Percentage ones will not stack with percentage ones. So, they both stack on enemies. And here you have it. We reduce even more the resistances, which means we deal even more damage to them. And also, the completed relic bonus pierce resistance. So, this is the build. When it comes to attributes, I spend 1 point on strength, 1 on dexterity, nothing else. 1 strength, 1 dexterity, 1 strength, 1 dexterity. This is what I did, this is what I will keep doing. Average damage is good for such a build, which tries to be balanced between damage output and survivability. Attack speed is almost perfect. Casting speed is okay, I don't really need casting speed. And movement speed is very, very good, and it gets buffed up when we use this one. So, this is the build is very simple, and the gameplay is very simple. All you need to remember is that you attack with this one, then you attack with this one. Let's charge up a little bit, and let's go kill a couple of enemies.
Traveler, please, you're my... without this medicine.
For you to see some gameplay. This was Warwind. We also have this effect, the thunderclap, which is happening because we use the fog.
The way is clear. Now I can make
the fog has the skill activated on attack. When we charge up, we can see that we get some buffs there to our damage output. We have Shrine of XP. We could say that this is a very typical melee build, and it is a very, very simple one. It is a build that will be very good to players that like having a few skills. They don't like playing piano builds, as we call them. And they like having only a couple of skills to use. And here all you do is to use the basic attacks, these two. And sometimes you hit this one, or this one to move faster. And this is a battle standard which you activate when things get rough.
The necklace! I wonder...
Very simple and very effective and very powerful. We We can see now 52 at 77% under the effects of onslaught. This is it. As you can see, this is how it goes. Super duper simple. Yeah. So this is the gameplay. I'm not going to play more. I don't want to keep you occupied more to this video, because the gameplay is exactly as you saw it right now. There is nothing more to it. Unless you use this skill, the soul drain, which you use on enemies. It is a very nice skill effect. But this also has a low cooldown. The cooldown, the recharge is 2 minutes. But anyway, you can also use that one every now and then. So guys, this is the Troglodyte build. The build based on items, monster, infrequent items that drop from Troglodytes. And soon enough, I guess, I will live stream some more gameplay with this build. It is a very, very nice build that you can relax very easily with this build, because there are not many skills for you to use. The build is very powerful when it comes to survivability, especially in the first 3 acts of the game. It will be very easy to go through. And yeah, we can see that this is a very nice build. So guys, thanks for watching this video. I'll be back very soon with more videos and live streams. Have fun whatever you do. Subscribe to this channel if you want to keep being updated with much more content that is always coming here. We will have much more content of Diablo 2 Resurrected, Darksiders franchise, the whole franchise, and of course Titan Quest, which is the main game for myself and this channel as a content creator. So, I'll see you very soon again. Have a good one.